Hi there. Let's talk about the first major project that will be due. At the end of every 4 weeks, there will be a major project, and there will be two at the very end of the semester that will be due. Now, for the daily work, the way that I take a grade on the daily work, or your teacher in your school would take the grade, is by looking at your activity in Moodle. And by that, they can see that you are going and looking at listening to the different lessons, etc. However, it's really up to you to just do the assignments without having that over your head. The daily assignments all lead up to the major projects, so it's completely to your advantage. I mean, it's not like it's to your advantage to seriously listen to the lessons and then go and experiment with the software and do the things that I ask you to do. It's to your advantage to do that. It's not like other classes where you're getting information and then you take a test that determines whether you remember that information or not. So I'm showing you how to do something. And if you don't listen to the lessons, you're not going to know how to do it. But my goal is that you're going to find it, you're going to really enjoy yourself and have so much fun that it wouldn't be even a consideration that you would try and skip the work. Okay, first major project. We're going to do an audio recording of a rap song that you write and perform. Now, as far as the subject matter for your rap song, it's got to be clean cut. This is high school. It has to be the subject matter should be something that you know about. That's always the best sort of a composition. And it should be something that you would be pleased to have your teacher or your principal or your parents listen to, and it wouldn't be upsetting to them. So that's kind of a really simple guideline there. But anyway, keep it clean cut, and I'll be doing one too. Of course, mine will be an old lady rap. And I have to confess right now, when it comes to composition, lyrics are my weakness. I mean, I can be. It's just hard for me. It's harder for me to come up with good lyrics than it is melody and rhythm and the musical elements. So, the songs that I've written in the past, the lyrics are usually silly. But we'll see. I haven't created it yet, right at this point. So we're going to use a little program called Tux Paint to help us come up with ideas for lyrics. And also, there are several websites that have help you find rhyming words, and we'll use those as well. We're going to compose the drum beat in Hydrogen, and the first lesson in Hydrogen is you'll have this first week. So it's really, really easy to use. We'll export it to a WAV file, and then finally, we will import the drum beat in Audacity. That's our program we use to record our voices. And then that will be on one track, and then we'll record our rap on another track. And mix them, meaning all that means is that adjust volumes so it's a balanced sound, like you don't have the voice part too loud or the instrumental part too loud, that they fit. Okay, now one thing, you'll see that I have included the SpongeBob episode on imagination, and then that's just to get you thinking about that. This class is all about imagination. You know, you're gonna need it. That's what it's for. But basically, people, you know, all of you have an imagination, but I don't know. A lot of times in school, we sort of discourage imagination, and you may have sort of lost it along the way, you know, just by, you know, learning information, taking tests, memorizing information, taking tests. Okay, so we hope here that you will get your imagination back. All little kids have imaginations. You know, you just put blocks and toys in front of them, and they make up a game, you know. And sometimes if they have dolls or action figures, you know, they'll have conversations with each other, the little characters. And, you know, so you had an imagination. If you don't feel like you have one now, you had one. The other thing that I want to mention right here, I also included a link to the YouTubes. They have a really great little instructional video on copyrights. And that is, learning about copyright is a very, very important thing for you. And that is one reason why everything that we're going to do is going to be original work. Because, you know, if you're going to put something on YouTube, you can't use someone else's stuff. You know, now for class assignments and, you know, there's, you know, in the past, you have probably used other people's videos, other people's pictures, other people's lyrics, etc. But in the real world, if you're using someone else's stuff, you know, you're breaking copyright law. Especially if you don't give them credit. But even if you give them credit, you have to have permission for most things. So, anyway, I want you to watch that and think about it very seriously, because, you know, it's something we need to know about. So, okay, just want you thinking as you are doing all your different assignments this week. Have this in the back of your mind. Okay, I'm going to be writing a rap. I'm going to create the drum beat for it. We're going to record it. So, okay. Thank you.